Good evening to you all. Welcome you all for the first broadcast of webinar series organized by the Sri Lanka Association for Child Development. Sri Lanka Association of Child Development is an organization consisting of multidisciplinary team professionals who, and also parents and all the professions who are sort of working towards the well-being of the child development. So this includes upbringing of the normally developing children, as well as the children who need some developmental support. So the first of our webinar series is on Down syndrome children who needs special care by a team of professionals for them to come to their normal life status. So as you can see, the name Down is not really Down. We can make it up. Down is due to the name of the person who invented it, and it's a genetic syndrome, as you know. So I'm sure there are many professionals joining with us, as well as we have included the parents and anybody who is interested in Down syndrome. The theme today is Yes, We Can. So it's a Down syndrome child saying that yes, we can do it as any other child in the community. So we have four talks programmed for today, and actually this is done by the multidisciplinary team who really work for Down syndrome. Actually, we feel that it's not just one individual looking after these children, but there are many professionals who work towards the betterment of this child. So we have a physiotherapist, an occupational therapist, a speech and language pathologist, as well as a community pediatrician looking at different aspects of development and the upbringing of the normal kind of ensuring that they get the best of care that we can award to them and the parents. So let's, without further ado, let me start with Ms. Diniti Pereira.
Today, my topic is basic motor skills for children with Down syndrome. As our madam said, the theme of our webinar is Yes, We Can. So, what we can do as a physiotherapist for children with Down syndrome? We can assist these babies to live as independently as possible. That is our main aim. Not only physiotherapists, all the members of multidisciplinary teams wish, and their aim is them to live as independently as possible. So as a physiotherapist, we have different goals and we for assist them to live as independently as possible. We should achieve different goals in different perspectives. As a physiotherapist, we have different goals according to the child assessment, but these are main goals that we have to achieve during our treatment sessions. First one is reach milestone within minimum time period, and second one, minimize the development of the compensatory movements. Third one, prevent or minimize from developing postural, balance, and gait problems. And last one, reduce adverse effect on musculoskeletal system. In this presentation, I mainly focus on basic motor skills and its associated problems. As we know, hypertonia and hyperflexibility are two main characteristic features of Down syndrome. So these things can increase joint dislocations and retarded motor skills. As I said in my topic, it can retarded motor skills. So hypotonia, that is decreased muscle tone, it can give negative effect on the proprioceptive feedback from muscles as well as joints, and this can reduce the coefficiency of co-contractions of muscles and postural reaction. And when we consider about hyperflexibility, it means hypermobility. It increases the joint mobility. This can cause lack of postural control. And together with failure of co-contractions of muscle, it can negatively impact on joint stability. These things can cause retarded of motor skills together with hormonal problems and medical, sometimes surgical problems. When we consider about milestones, as I told earlier, I love to talk about motor, gross motor activities as a physiotherapist. We know typical children, they usually get some of the gross motor activities within a limited time period. But when we consider about children with Down syndrome, there is marked delay. So as a physiotherapist, if we do early intervention for these kids, we can reduce that retardation. When we consider about compensatory movements, let's go through this video. Have you noticed this child is trying to reciprocal crawling, but that crawling method is not 100% the proper crawling method. That is because of this baby is trying to use compensatory movements because of this hypermobility, hypotonia, and sometimes because of these sensory problems. So, and let's go to the second picture. This is some kind of bear pose. And sometimes these kids use this pose as a locomotion method, as a what we call bear gait. These postures and these compensatory movements we can reduce because because of these compensatory movements, they overuse some group of muscles and they inactive some group of muscles. So we have to treat for these things. And third aim in my presentation is we have to minimize or prevent postural and sometimes balance and gait problems. Please go through the first picture. In this picture, she is trying to maintain her sitting position, but this sitting position is not so good because she is trying to maintain this cross-leg sitting position with curved back, hunched back, hypotic back, and posterior tilted pelvis, and head. She is trying to keep her head on her upper back. She is trying to rest her head on her upper back. This is some kind of hypotic posture. In the second picture, she is trying to use a wide base to compensate her balance, and she is having hypermobile hips. She's used that position to maintain her balance and the posture. So if they go through these posture for a long period for their lifetime, they will end up with mechanical problems. So we have to definitely address these problems as we saw as earlier. This is the locomotion gait problems. Usually these babies trying to use wide base, they keep their legs apart, and sometimes they use knees stiff. They don't like to bend their knees, hips, and ankles while they are moving forward because they feel that their balance is not so good, and they use that overactive muscles to walk. So as a physiotherapist, we have to address these problems. As the final aim of my presentation, we have to minimize adverse effect on musculoskeletal system. As we know, because of this hypertonia and hypermobility, their muscle length and their is not in proper place. So because of that, their muscle tone reduced and muscle strength is not so good. So as a physiotherapist, we have to address their muscle strength by doing therapeutic activities. And because of this strength lag and poor strength, they can have poor endurance, muscular endurance. These two factors can cause physical inactivity. So we have to address these things at the beginning of their career, because otherwise they will end up with obese and they will have definitely mechanical problems, degenerative changes in joints and obesity in their latter part of their life. So this is my take home message. We have to do early intervention for make their life quality. So early intervention is the best way to get rid of these problems, and the family members' role. Because sometimes in Sri Lankan setup, some parents and family think that this therapeutic activities mainly focus on the baby and the mother. That is the wrong message. So father, siblings, sometimes grandparents have to play a major role to improve their kid. And we have to encourage play activities rather than giving exercises, because, and the other thing is, we have to select good toys and it has to be very interested to the baby. And we have to have patience to gain their motor skills. Let's go through this video. Here we use a pen to make this baby to same height sansaring. We have to give time for the baby to do that. He is doing same height transferring. We have to be very patient up to he is doing the activity. These are playing activities. We are trying to encourage him to standing up from the floor to stand in position and maintain. And we can do dynamic strengthening balancing exercises with ropes, whatever he likes to play. In this video, both father and mother do activities with the kid. without physiotherapy, a child can with Down syndrome could end up with postural, balance, gait problems. Sometimes in their later stage, they will have some rheumatological, orthopedic conditions. So we have to do physiotherapy to prevent and minimize these conditions. With these physiotherapy interventions, we can do, yes, madam, we can win these problems. These two pictures, that they are self-employed because of they have proper balance, coordination, and proper walking patterns, and because of their good IQ levels and all the things, they are self-employed. This is what we finally need. This is one of our baby who's trying to run. As a physiotherapist, we can assist them to live as independently as possible. Thank you.
Our viewers will have questions to ask from the Niti, which we will have a panel discussion at the end of the presentation. So if you have any questions, you can post it to the Q&A section so that we will try and answer most of it that is possible. So next up is our occupational therapist, Mr. H. Surapulli, who is an occupational therapist working with kids with developmental difficulties. And he also deals with Down syndrome babies. And over to you, Mahesh.
Good evening, everybody. Yes, our madam say, yes, we can improve every aspect of their life. Yes, we can normalize them, our community, as much as possible as a normal child. Today I am addressing how to occupation therapy intervention individual with Down syndrome. The occupation therapy practitioners guide individuals and families to reach their potential throughout the life. Research, education, and advocacy have led to advance in therapy, which have had a huge effect on opportunities available to individuals with Down syndrome. You can see today in the world, people with Down syndrome are graduating high school, going to college, participating recreational activities in their communities, living independently, and advocating for their rights. As an OT, occupation therapy intervention should be as soon as a diagnosis to Down syndrome is established and should continue through the individual life. Occupation therapy helps them to develop physical and mental well-being person. As a Down child, the both of their section, physical and mental, they have problems. We help them to overcome their problems both side their life. Under that, I am talking about very few topics: motor skills, self-care skills, sensory skills, visual skills, social and academic behaviors, common mental health, play and leisure. Under motor skills, we can divide it by two: fine motor and gross motor. Under fine motor, there are common areas of difficulty for a lot of children with Down syndrome are more likely to have fine motor difficulties due to cognitive and neural developmental difficulties. Now we take small example, short fingers making mastering fine motor activities harder. So there are a lot of fun activities provide work on the fine motor difficulties. As an OT, we can provide lot of fun activities to develop their fine motor difficulties. The one of our patient, they practice fine motor activities in their home with his mother very simply. But very simple activity, we have a huge therapeutic value. What I think about, he used for the glue and paste the dal nuts, this picture. This is big outcome with activity. You think how they are, when he goes to school, he can't, when other children's making some draws and putting some glue on the papers, but he can't. He's highly depressed. I can't perform that activities. We can arrange these activities in home and we can produce the independent person our community. Look. He's concentrating. Improve his concentration, attention, memory, fine motor skills, reasoning, problem solving, a lot of things include this activity actually. It's very simple one. The everyone can do this kind of activities, but finally outcome very big. Okay. Then I am talking about our huge part as a occupational therapy, self-care skills. Activities of daily living training and instrumental activities of daily living. Under activities of daily living, eating, toileting, bathing, lot of day-to-day activities. Under IDL, instrumental activities of daily living, how to manage pen or pencil, how to manage cutleries, how to manage school bag, how to open school bag, zip, how to manage pencil case, how to manage water bottle, the lot of activities include. He can't perform that activities, is actually highly depressed in his community and school. We can provide with very, very simple activities and independent to reach their independent life. The activities that other children may develop naturally, such as toileting, dressing, and feeding can present significant challenge with Down syndrome. The OT can identify which task and component they are struggling with and provide one-to-one training, advice on equipment, therapeutic techniques, strategy planning to training ADL and IADL. Then now I am talking about, we are special, very, very special part as a occupation therapy, sensory skills. The child with Down syndrome often have difficulty in integrating the sensory stimulation received from the environment around them to produce appropriate responses. As OTs, that is skilled in sensory integration techniques, will establish what areas of sensory processing child with Down syndrome is experiencing and will address them to advise, program, and direct therapy session. We identify what kind of sensory problem they have, vestibular, proprioception, auditory, tactile, gustatory, a lot of sensory problem they have. We identify what kind of sensory problem they have and we arrange the proper activities they or our therapy centers we can overcome this problem. Then I'm talking about visual perceptual skills, the ability to do what is visual perception, the ability to do process what they have seen and respond with meaningful movement. Some of examples: confusing, distinguish between left and right, problem with the alphabetic order or other sequences, difficulty in identify similarities and difference between letters. Think about, we can arrange simple jigsaw puzzles activities, simple color dominoes activities, simple number dominoes activities, and simple letter English letter activities to make words some words. We can overcome that problem and we can solve that problem very easily. Then I am talking about social and academic behavior. Under that, I'm talking very few topics: attention and concentration, challenging classroom environment, handwriting difficulties. Under attention and concentration, if a child finds focus and activity or task or sustained period of time challenging, they are like to find the expectation of classroom environment challenging. The OT Wealth helps down child develop the skills needed for the success in integration into class, with management of basic self-care, helping children develop independence and confidence. We regularly assist parents, classroom staff, teachers to develop their skills. Under, I am not talking about much communication skills, but we can develop their communication. So communication is a building blocks for build up good relationship with others. But he can't talk with others in the classroom or institute. How he deal with his emotions, that's why he's highly aggressive or highly depressed. We can solve that problem and we can arrange some therapy for their homes very easily. Look my video, one of our child, how to manage his communication skills. Right. Then I'm talking about our huge topic, handwriting difficulties. As an OT, we have a responsibility to build a child, our society, good handwriting, productive child. Good handwriting is an essential life skills and the building blocks for success at school. We give some activities and identify what kind of problem they have. We have a special capacity for activity analysis. Those are some of common problem Down's child with have: poor spacing, positioning of letter and words, discomfort gripping pencil or any length of period time. We can give some adaptation, difficulties of concentration or poor behaviors in the classroom, weak fine motor skills and hand strength. We can improve the short, very simple activities with strength their hand muscles, hypothenar, thenar, lumbricals, like all the muscles we can strength individually or group-wise. The excessive tiredness after short period of time, we can engage with the play activities and we can solve that problem very easily. Look one of our child, how to activating his writing skills in the home. Okay. Then I'm going to very huge topic again. I am not talk about much because of less time. common mental health. I am doing tell very simply, general anxiety as an occupation therapy, we are using anxiety management techniques. The repetitive and obsessive compulsive behaviors, we know they are cognitive are varied. We are using some level of cognitive behavior therapy. Sleep-related difficulties, we are introduced them to structure of the day. Depression, we are arranged some indoor and outdoor games. And group therapy, some music therapy, some grammar therapy we can arrange. And depression, we can arrange some like this. And neurophysiological problem, nocturnal illness, we have a special technique for the prevent that. And ADHD problem, we know why they have a unrest, they are change their behaviors. We can arrange a lot of sensory integration therapy techniques and solve that problem. And stuck inflexible behavior and social withdrawalness, and we can arrange some functions, we can arrange some religious activities, we can arrange some group therapies, we can arrange some indoor and outdoor games and overcome those problems. And ultimately, they have to, in our society, sometimes 60 years or more than 60, it's varying from person to person. They have to spend their time productively, help children develop the organized skill needed to get their most for their day. We have to activity that encourage the highest level of function and independently. We introduce them to play and leisure activities, but we have to, our institute or through the, our society or and home visit, or we can change what kind of activities, what kind of leisure activities they need. Throughout their life, as a multidisciplinary approach, we can keep them to very happy in our society. Thank you very much, all of you. Okay,
thank you very much, Mahesh, for that very comprehensive talk on how you deal with Down syndrome with regard to occupational therapy. And we have our next speaker, Ms. Ashari Veerasingha, who is our speech and language pathologist at Colombo South Teaching Hospital, who will be talking to us how they deal with baby Down syndrome at a very early stage of life, and then how she takes it forwards thereafter.
Thank you, Madam Saraji, for the kind introduction. My name is Ashari Veerasingha. I'll be talking about this topic, enhanced quality of life of children with Down syndrome, speech and language therapist's perspective. I will describe the following areas throughout the presentation. What is speech and language therapy? What is communication? Role of speech and language therapist when working with children with Down syndrome? What we can do speech and language system? Things we can do to improve communication, take home messages, final goal. As you all know, speech and language therapists are healthcare professionals. They work to prevent, assess, diagnose, and treat speech, language, social communication, cognitive communication, and swallowing disorders in children and adults. Before we talking in depth on speech and language therapy and Down syndrome, let's see what communication is. Communication requires two or more people in order to share thoughts and ideas. Communication is a two-way process. It requires sender, receiver, and mode. During the process, sender, receiver, and mode should work precisely. Otherwise, communication breakdown can be occurred. Speech and language therapists act many roles when working with children with Down syndrome. They can be a facilitator, friend, educator, playmate, and therapist. When considering communication and eating related skills, these associated problems can be seen. Mainly neonates with Down syndrome may have sucking and swallowing issues. Some swallowing difficulties may persist, and they may show signs of aspiration for different food consistencies. Also, they may show difficulties in understanding and expressing. Most of children have articulation errors also. Other than that, hearing issues, literacy issues, issues in social interaction can be seen. This slide will discuss what we do in therapy. It includes early identification, comprehensive assessment, diagnosis, it means communication diagnosis, and intervention plan. Therapy should start since birth. We highly recommend therapy from day one. According to many researchers, first 3 years of life shows rapid development in language skills. And we can take first 5 years is very important for any child with or without Down syndrome. Increased understanding of Down syndrome and early intervention make a big difference in their lives of both children and adults with Down syndrome. When the child comes to speech and language therapy session, we initially assess the following areas. Pre-verbal skills. It includes attention, eye contact, turn-taking. Likewise, comprehension. Comprehension means level of understanding. Understanding level of objects, pictures, understanding of daily situations like bathing, eating, changing clothes, and understanding of simple commands or complex commands. Likewise, expression can be verbal or non-verbal. It can be some children can express only using single word. Some children may use 2-word level sentences, 3-word level sentences according to their skill level. Fourth one is oromotor skills. Then cognitive skills will be assessed also. It includes matching, sorting, concepts knowledge, size, colors, numbers, such as. Also academic skills will be assessed, but we have to tell we don't work on academic skills. Special education teachers will address that part. We can identify the gap between the chronological age and developmental age throughout the assessment process. Always there can be a gap in children with Down syndrome. So we are trying to support them to minimize that gap. As you can see, many modes of communication are there. Spoken language is first, is usually what we do. There are the other ways, sign language, writing, gestures, facial expressions, and using augmentative alternative communication systems, likewise. Normally we use more than one as communication mode. Assessment findings will be helped to decide which mode of communication is more suitable for the child. If the child is unable to speak, we can use AAC system. It can be high tech or low tech. We can use picture based systems or high tech machine based systems. For that, when working with children with Down syndrome, there are few facts to keep in your mind. Children of Down with Down syndrome are visual learners, so they learn through more looking, watching, other than hearing. For example, just saying word table, you have to show it, then describe it by adding words like it's a big table, it's made by wood, likewise. You have to also provide language-rich environment. It means you should not doing everything to the child. You should give the chance to request, ask, and comment. You can give him choices. If you want the ball or bat, like. Keep in mind, every child is unique. So identify your child's strength and interests. It will more helpful you to find out more interested play activities. Other one, please reduce screening time. Screens cannot substitute parents or parents' valuable time. Basically, engage them within play activities. Take home messages. Early intervention has better outcome. Also, early referrals to speech and language therapy services is must. Include them in daily activities. Play and talk intensively with them. Collaboration among children, parents, caregivers, siblings, teachers also help them to learn more and learn faster. because it happens in the natural setting. As speech and language therapists, our final goal to make them as functional communicators. Children's skills vary from each other. According to their skill level, IQ level, they may show different abilities. But we have to recognize them and go ahead according. At the age of 6 years, we should decide which education system is most suitable for them. Select them and work on that. At the age of 15 years of age, we should decide what is suitable for the training method. Very few can have a career. It can be a long process, but keep in mind, we can do it. They are not disabled, they are differently abled. Then we can win the challenge. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ashari, for that insight on how you work with Down syndrome babies from day one itself. Let's move on to our last talk by Dr. Manuri Chandaratna, who is a community pediatrician and who works in the multidisciplinary care team, as well as working with these children very closely. And we'll listen to Manuri, how she worked with the team and to make these children having a wonderful time, or like making their future a better one. Over to you, Manuri.
It's We Are Together, an inclusive society for children with Down syndrome. What should be our goal? What is inclusivity? How do we include children with Down syndrome? Benefits a parent's perspective of a parent with a child with Down syndrome. What could be going through their minds? What will the future be for my child? Will he ever be able to be with the typically developing children? Will he have friends? Will my child read and write? My child can read and write, but the school concentrates on other activities only. Why isn't the school interested in teaching my child? I know the child had during the first year of his life with therapy, but what will the future hold for him? He will forever live with Down syndrome. These are some of the typical things which would be going through parents' minds. So, can we make a difference? Can we give solutions for this? Yes, we can. And we do it through early intervention and inclusion. We have had some inputs on what early intervention is through the presentations that we had before. But this presentation would mainly concentrate on inclusion. What is inclusion? It is an educational process by which all students, including children with disability and typically developing children, educate together. It should be for most time of the school day. It is recommended that at least more than 80% of the meeting, and where the child with Down syndrome or with disability is educated in a special education setting and mainstreamed only for a small time period, is not considered as inclusion. Inclusion welcomes, values, empowers, and supports diverse academic and social learning among students of all abilities. So in our setup for inclusion, at least the children should be with the mainstream in schooling for more than at least 50% of the time of the school day. And why do we need inclusion for children with Down syndrome? It is their right. It is their right for education. And as a country, we have rectified and signed the UN Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities. And we have a responsibility to abide by them. And we have a responsibility to provide them with equal chance for primary and secondary education, vocational training, adult education, and lifelong learning. It is the Article 24 of the UN Convention for Child Rights of Persons with Disability. And also, research has shown that when children with Down syndrome are included with mainstream schooling, they show much more enhanced abilities in spoken language, reading and writing, maths, general knowledge, and social independence. And also they have a positive impact on employment outcome. Obviously, when you are in an inclusive society, inclusive step in the education, then when you move out to the greater society, when you reach out for employment options, you know what you are dealing with. And also, up to date, there are no research showing that there is any benefit of education in a special education class or in a special education school for children who have Down syndrome. So this graphically represents what inclusion is. So inclusion benefits children with Down syndrome as well as typically developing children in that class. What are the benefits for children with Down syndrome? As I said before, it shows better academic excellence and social independence. Also, they will have role models for positive speech and behavior. Mind you, children with Down syndrome are imitators. They copy others. So when they have positive role models, they will have an example as into how they should behave and what goals they should reach. And also, with inclusion, the typically developing children also benefits. This research has reported greater skills in mathematics, even though research has not shown any greater impact in reading and writing skills of typically developing children when they are included together. It has shown that there is a consistent pattern in the scores that they achieve. And also this will create an environment where they would learn acceptance, tolerance, patience and friendship. And at the highest setting, what we should aim at is a universal design for learning, which is beneficial for both children with Down syndrome, children with any other disability, and typically developing children who educate together in the same setting, and certain children may be needing accommodation. And also I should say the research have shown that teachers showed greater satisfaction in their job when they work in an inclusive environment. So what are our strengths? Down syndrome, children with Down syndrome have a strong visual awareness. They have visual learning skills, they are visual learners. And also they have the ability to use sign, gesture, and visual support. Ability to learn using the written words. There is a strong desire and ability to learn from their peers. Like I said before, they imitate others and they take cues from them. So what are our drawbacks? During the other three presentations, you all should have grasped that there are certain drawbacks and there are certain areas which they need more support in. Like our physiotherapist spoke, there will be delayed motor skills, fine and gross motor skills, and there will be manipulation difficulties. When you write letters, it would be a barrier. And also, even though these children are visual learners, certain medical conditions like cataract will lead to visual impairment. There will be hearing impairment. So this has to be sorted out to get the fullest potential. Also, they have short-term auditory memory. Therefore, they have problems in concentration and processing. They also do have difficulties with generalization, thinking, and reasoning. So knowing these limitations, knowing these areas, what we could do, as stated in the previous presentation, are working from early life through early intervention towards inclusivity so that they, by the time that they are included in a school and then in the society, they are ready to face those challenges, and also the society around will be accommodating their needs. So they will be needing accommodations. This is to graphically represent the difficulties and the challenges they might have. So when we manage a child with Down syndrome, the whole team has to come in together. It's a multidisciplinary act. There will be doctors, therapists, and also parents and teachers working together. And from medical side, there will be pediatricians, there will be psychiatrists, like I said, like in an initial presentation, it was stated the mental problems that these children could go through. So the psychiatrists will be playing a role. And also the therapists will be helping in coming in, taking the best outcome from these children. So what do we need to focus on overall? We need to include these children in all conversations. When it is in the mainstream schools, if they let these children to be in one place in a corner by themselves all alone, that is not going to work for them. They need inclusion in every conversation, every teaching learning activity, which is done in the normal mainstream class. And also we should allow the child to learn from experience, to become a problem solver. And we should learn them, teach them through example, through being a role model, what is appropriate physical contact, how to deal with others. And also especially parents and also teachers should be supportive rather than being overprotective. We should empower them to act according to their age, to be age appropriate. And like I said again and again, they copy and they imitate. So there should be good role models, peers and classmates around to support a child with Down syndrome. And the main focus should be on making them independent. This is to make some inspiration. The limitations that we talk about are in the typical society, not in children with Down syndrome. There are academics who have gained university degrees who have Down syndrome. There are supermodels, playwrights, musicians, entrepreneurs, athletes, designers. These are world famous characters who also have Down syndrome. So let's not let Down syndrome define them, because they have a huge magnitude of capacity, and it is our responsibility to help them reach it. And it is our duty to make them achieve it by providing them chances, by providing them support and accommodation. So these are my references. So I think now we could go, if you have any questions, we could go into a panel discussion. Thank you.
So I think this is the first of our webinar series, and Sri Lanka Association for Child Development is planning on webinars every fortnightly, Wednesdays at the same time. We also will be uploading this to our Facebook page on that is Sri Lanka, if you type Sri Lanka Association for Child Development, and also the YouTube channel, Sri Lanka Association for Child Development, and then you can visualize it again. So this is actually a live broadcast in the Facebook at the moment. So thank you very much, all of you, for joining in. My special thanks goes to the four speakers who did wonderfully in their presentations, and this is actually what they do day to day in their practice. So the multidisciplinary teams in the whole island have probably are taking up these tasks. So thank you very much again, Dr. Manuri, Diniti, Mahesh and Ashari, for taking their time off and doing this presentation. And also for I would like to thank our sponsor Allergan Pharma and Dr. Emil and Mr. Lakita for helping us with these presentations and setting up the Zoom platform, etc. And lastly, to thank you all for joining in with us. Thank you very much and have a pleasant night.